Hey everybody, in this video we will create a video mockup for the video recorded from my iPhone and imported into Artboard Studio. For that, first I'm going to the mockup section here from the Add Items menu here and looking for an iPhone mockup. This technique works with any type of mockups like packaging or let's say apparel, so you can apply videos to any mockup with the same technique. First, I'm just dragging and dropping this iPhone mockup to my canvas and closing the left toolbar. Okay, now I have this video and I want this video to be placed on the mockup item. Unfortunately, there is no simple way to do that. Right now, it only works with images in Artboard Studio, so you cannot apply a video. As you see, even though I put the video inside the customization tab, it doesn't play here. But with this technique, with this hack kind of, you can apply any sort of videos on the device screens with a perspective. First of all, I need to create a new artboard. For that, go to the left toolbar and drawing an artboard on my canvas and including the iPhone mockup. Then I just position or resize as I like. In this case, I'm just using 16:9 ratio for this video because I can use this video later on my social media or on my slide deck or Figma slide or website banner. So I'm just going with 16:9 ratio. As you see, I just placed the mockup image beside this artboard. Now for this technique, I need to duplicate the mockup item on the artboard. So for that, I'm pressing Command and D. And as you see, it creates exactly the same mockup item on my canvas with the same position. So in order to align again, I just choose both mockup image layers and just aligning like that. First of all, you need to rename your layers in this case because we will use masking technique, so it can be confused. You can be confused in the next step. First, mockup layer, I will rename this as screen. And here in the mockup artboard section here, I just want to make the iPhone mockup surface opacity 100%, but the main image 0%. So what this does is it just shows you the surface layer like this. So if I change the color here, let's say I apply, oops, the wrong one. If I apply any other color here, as you see, it just reflects on the surface, the mask area. So the first layer is screen and it only shows the screen design. Again, aligning the mockup items like that. For the second layer, I'm just renaming my layer as main image, which is I'm going to hide the surface this time with 0% opacity and just keep the main image in 100% opacity, which again, this also just hides the entire surface masking area. Then again, aligning the layers and just choosing both mockup layers here. As you see on my layers panel, you see it's both selected. Going to the top bar and mask in option here. Now, as you see, if I change the background color of the artboard, now the mockups just mask with each other. It created a group for me. And as you see, the screen layer on top, the main image just below. So this is a mask group. But just because I just choose the screen opacity 100% and main image 0, it just masks and intersect these two layers into each other. Now, whatever I place on the background, let's say I change the background color like that. Now, this part behaves like a transparent place that you can easily place anything behind. Now, it's time to bring the video inside the artboard. And in this example, I just want to put this video into the screen. So I just need to go to the layers panel again and move this video layer just behind the group. Let me rename the group again. I say iPhone mockup. So now the video layer is just right behind the mockup layers. But because this part is transparent, I can see the video behind. After you select the video, you can also lock this layer in order to easily select the video layer here. I just choose the video layer, going to the top bar again, and now I'm choosing perspective transform. This function gives me 4 points that I can just move around like this and distort the perspective of the video layer like that. In order to perfectly position the points, I can easily zoom in and zoom out and be sure those green lights are just straight and in parallel with the phone screen area. So moving this point again, like this. Again, you can zoom in infinitely to position the points, transform perspective, transform points perfectly. Going to the bottom side, and again, positioning my point, zooming out and zooming into this part, and there you go. Now it looks good to me, and there you go. Now, if you press the play button here, because this artboard contains a video layer, as you see, there's a play button here also. If I play the video now, as you see, the video plays right inside the iPhone screen and it looks perfect. In this case, you can also apply any color on the background. For this design, let me apply the same dark green. If I look at the layers now, as you see, now I have the iPhone mockup group. It contains both mockup layers, and I have the video layer down there. Let's say you are happy with the video. It's playing nicely, but you want to crop or trim or split some parts of the video. You can just open the timeline editor here and you're going to see all the entire video layer right there. For example, in the beginning of the video, it just stays a while. So I just want to crop that part. For that, I'm just selecting the video layer and dragging this part a little bit and moving the video layer again to the beginning. So if I play now, I need to, I think, crop more, trim more this part. So if you play the video right now, as you see, it instantly starts with scrolling, but now it's too much. Let me just trim less. Yeah, this is perfect. You can always change the duration. For example, with this, in this case, the video is 5 seconds, which means 5,000 milliseconds. So I'm just making this 10,000 in order to get a 10-second video. Now, if I play the video again, it plays the entire and scrolls. It plays my video right inside the iPhone with the perspective. Perfect. Let's say you want to animate this entire layers too. So you can select the group layer, press shift and select the video layer too, or just simply drag and select them all. Press command G. Now you created a new group. But just because this video now inside that group, you created kind of a nested video layer. It still plays and does the job, but now you have this layer and you can enable the start animating and add keyframes to animate this video and mockup layer all together. So because my animation mode is active, I can just place and position, and it instantly creates the first keyframes for me automatically. Let me just scale up more. Let's say I want this animation to start with this position and somewhere in the first 1 second on 1, 2 seconds, let's say 1 second, I just want this to scale down smoothly and position in the middle of the canvas. Yeah. Now, because I am doing these changes on my canvas in the first second, it created other keyframes for me too. So if I hit the play button here, as you see, it plays the video. At the same time, it also scales down and positions the phone perfectly. But this animation is too linear, so you want to make it more smoother. Just select the animation layer here and go to easing options. Here I'm choosing cubic boat, which is going to give you more smoother animation, as you see. Now it scales down, but looks fancier and smoother. If you are okay with the animation, you can select the artboard from the top bar here. Go to the export section video. And here you can choose the keyframe settings you need, all the format you need. In this case, I'm choosing MP4. So just hit export video and it just renders my video real quick. So now I can take this video and go and create a social media post, go and paste this video into Figma slides to create a slide deck, or I can just place it on a website to use as a banner. This is how we create video mockups in Artboard Studio. If you have any questions, just let me know in the comment section below. And take care. Bye.